I think in general, more and more decisions are made based on data. It can impact how people think about a whole range of civic issues, things about housing, things about policing, environmental regulations. It's important that people can access it and engage with it in a really meaningful way that allows them to be part of the conversation. So that's what got me interested in using more like artistic approaches to represent data. Cities or organizations are making their data public. Often the next step of like making sure people know about it and can access it and can do something with it is really challenging, or is like sort of a gap in the system. I like to try and do something that can like fill that gap and make the dialogue richer for everyone involved. Before grad school, I worked at Silent Spring Institute, which is a research nonprofit in the Boston area that works on environmental health. One thing I wanted to do there was to create artistically focused data displays that could be used in some of these studies to share data with participants in the study. So a lot of my work was already really interdisciplinary, but when I was at the media lab, I think I learned to lean into that even more. In my master's work, I did a lot of textile-based data representations. Most of those were really closely tied to the work that I had done at Silent Spring and were in collaboration with folks there. The data clothing work was creating artistically focused data displays through garments that were not something an everyday person would wear, but could express the data in an interesting way and use all sorts of different fabrics and methods for displaying the data. The second piece of that was these data shirts that we made for each participant in the study had a design on them that represented the data that was found in that individual person's home. Big Purge Art was also related to that same study. That was these like basically huge pop-up laundry hampers that we put motors in so they could change their heights, and was intended to be something that like a bunch of people could experience together and just see like not only how did my data look, but how did my data look compared to other people's data. Most impactful is helping people make these things for themselves to reflect on data. It's really hands-on and it can be really slow too, so you can spend all sorts of time like stitching things or, you know, beading or adding all these details to something, and in all that time it's creating room for reflection. You're experiencing the data through your body by doing that, like the sewing action. So that's another piece that's really interesting to me. One of my hopes for this space is just that it can be used to create a different emotional environment for data or for information, and that can change who's part of the conversation.